Alright, welcome to game two. This seems pretty ideal. Anger might get a lot of value. Staticaster might get a lot of value. And he's mulling to five. Temple gonna bottom any land. Maybe not that land. Kinda like that one. I'm gonna bottom it anyway. Our hand is such a low curve. If we end up needing more lands, it'll be because we drew into something that requires more lands. Ugh. I was kind of hoping for any other 2-drop. Alright, I guess we're on the... Oh wait, no, I should just be Staticasting and Gorgon's heading. I was thinking I was like gonna flame speaker and Gorgon set it up again, but this is just way better. Way freaking better. Night Veil Spectre, deal. I'm gonna cast this card. And I think it's gonna be pretty good against you. Frostburn weird, not attacking, because there's no real reason. Note that if I ping his Frostburn Weird, mine will also die. Because they share a name or whatever. Well, that's awkward. Well, now we need to draw land. Super awkward. I guess I just play another Frostburn Weird. And wait until I can sweep his board. If I'd hit a land there, I would have attacked in. He probably would have blocked. And then on my second main, I could anger for the board. Jace? Sure. He probably draws here. Nope, he ticked up. Played another land. Sweep. I can't actually... Like, if I send both the Frostburn Weirds at Jace, if I was gonna pump one and actually deal a damage to the Frostburn Weird, then he could sacrifice to counter the Anger of the Gods on my second main. I should have played this as my first main. Swept this stuff aside. Well, I guess he would have countered it unless I paid one anyway. Yeah, there was no way for me to get value this turn. Or more value than what I'm getting anyway. Which isn't actually that much value, because the Anger is going to kill my Izzet Staticaster. Kind of a shame. But it puts me in good position for next turn. What if I just let it get countered there? Like, just used... I actually don't hate that. If I just, like, vend the Anger of the Gods when he sacked the Judge's Familiar. God. This card I can't beat versus these cards I can beat. I wonder what you're gonna put in your hand. Yeah. Awkward. And now we, like, don't have Anger of the Gods or Staticaster. Probably just gonna lose to this card. Well, this sucks. Good news is we have a lot of blockers. We're just gonna lose to this Jace, though. Grinding out card advantage, finding him more stuff, more masters. The white version of this deck gets to play Chain of the Rocks to just answer Master of Waves. I was thinking Staticaster would be like enough to keep all of this in check. Tidebinder Mage was really awkward, though. Maybe I can just, like, never tap this thing on my turn. Like, if I have the combo of Staticaster plus Gorgon's Head, I just have to, like... Because if he plays Tidebinder Mage with the ability on the stack, I can kill it. Oh, he plussed one to Jace, didn't he? Yeah. So attacking with Flamespeak here would be pretty lackluster. I guess I should have just played two Ash Zealots. I don't know. In a really awkward position. Jace matches up very well against Flamespeaker, for obvious reasons. I think we're gonna lose this match. It's not looking good, that's for sure. Turn and burn, sweet. Exactly the card I wanted him to hit off the top of my library. God. What you got, blue man? Drawing with Jace. Well, you're gonna get another one of these. The second master in play. Well, I guess I can Gorgon's Head. I was thinking that the elementals would be out of Staticaster range, but they're not really. Domestication, sure. That seems pretty good for you. Although I can just move the Gorgon's Head. Jace downticked. That's huge. Maybe wanted to save Anger for when he played the second Master of Waves here. But I also really wanted to get Jace off the board. So. You pick your poison, I guess. 3, 4, 5, 6, put me to 4. I think even if I can deal with these elementals, I'm still just going to lose to Master of Waves beatdown. Which is always the problem. Oh well. So I haven't quite solved this matchup, apparently. I thought Staticaster, Gorgon's Head would be good enough. And it's definitely good. I learned something about how to play the interaction in this matchup. However, I definitely don't have enough answers to Master of Waves. Other cards I can consider are like my own rapid hybridizations. I haven't really liked rapid hybridization in the other matchups. I've liked Turn and Burn and the Staticaster combo way more. But it might just be really good in this matchup. So that's something to think about. Alright, on to the next match.